Part two of our postgame interview, Wingate head coach Brian Good joins us for win number 99 here in this Bulldog career. So Wingate shoots almost 60%, 59 in the game, and they win it by 16 thanks to a Wingate record, 10 of 10 for Jeff Parker. A lot of good things today for Wingate. Coach, unlike the Tusculum game, you guys got out early and jumped all over Brevard. And, you know, kind of cruised there through the second half, some miscues offensively, turnovers. But, again, in a game like this, this was just an up-and-down affair. What did you like most about the way this team started and able to get that halftime lead?
Yeah, I mean, I think it'd be easy just to dismiss that, you know, they got seven guys and the biggest guy that plays is about 6'4". But it really presents some unique challenges to the way they play. That, you know, there is no real post-up game. Moose can shoot a three as good as he can go down on the block. And, you know, and all these little dribble handoffs on the perimeter with guys that can shoot the three. We made some adjustments of our normal defensive principles to guard all the things that they do. And I thought our guys did terrific. We had very, especially early, we were tuned into what we needed to do. You know they can shoot, but I've seen them in the past when teams start, you know, trying to chase them off the three-point line. Next thing you know, they're at the rim because the floor's so spread, it's hard to help. So you gotta, you know, our goal was to try to make them shoot, challenge three-pointers without, you know, getting up out of a stance and trying to just make them shoot over hands and try not to give up backdoor cuts. And I thought we did a really good job.
Now, you've been on your post players a little bit to be tough with the ball when those zones collapse. Jeff got some looks inside because he was able to fight through a couple double teams and muscle his way up. You know, Dion out right now, so Jeff had the spotlight, and he did well with it. 10 of 10, what a great night.
But, I mean, and as good as he was in the stats, I think the best thing he did tonight was his defense on Moose. I mean, Moose was 9 of 24. Moose didn't want anything to do with Jeff.
Right. Yeah.
When Jeff guarded him, the only thing he'd do is go out and shoot threes because he knew he couldn't score around him on the basket. So, you know, he had an all-around game today. It wasn't just a great offensive game. His I thought it started in the second half of Catawba. We started that game or the second half there, and he was two dunks, and he was ready to play, and he stayed focused, you know. Like you want a senior to do when one of his partners is out, you know, the old cliche, it's time to step up, but he did, and very proud of him for that.
How important were minutes like these for Terrell and a Keith Griffin? And, you know, I asked Jeff the same thing. You know, look back in this game, say we cruised his second half, and there was some wild play, but these are big minutes, big moments for some of these bench guys. Just figure out where they fit in and figure out, because you're going to need them to do the same thing they did today in big games down the way.
Yeah, and you know, the one of the things in our league that I think you have to be able to do is you have to adjust sometimes a little bit to who you're playing and what they do. And today, you know, Isaiah slides over to the four with Dion being out, and then Terrell's our backup there, and it worked really well because of the guys they had were really three men playing the four. So, you know, and we slid everybody a little bit into the next spot. We got, you know, we got some guy. We got Bryce extended minutes again, and he's been really solid. And, you know, Terrell was, other than, you know, probably throwing the ball away a couple times because he got excited, you know, Terrell puts it in the basket and throws it to the open guy. Sometimes it's just at the four he gets, a Curtis McMillan or Vinny Bailey or something. It's not a matchup he can win. But you know, we got Mars Hill and a couple of other teams where those guys they're going to see their minutes go up on those games. And then, you know, then we're going to play the other teams where I'm going to need Mark and I'm going to need his thickness and his strength to battle big guys. So, and I think that's what's really good about us right now is I think we've got some options and we can move guys around a little bit and play big, play small. You know, and obviously adapt a little bit and still play the way we want to play. So been really good for us today to let those guys get comfortable and play with the lead. You know, sometimes those guys are getting in and we're trying to get two good minutes out of them or three good minutes out of them, and it's a one possession game, or maybe we're behind. And today, when, you know, those guys are in, we had a nice little lead, and so you get to relax and just play basketball a little bit, and so it was good for them.
Another really good night shooting. I mean, you lost the Catawba game, but shot right around 50% tonight. Back in your home gym where you played two more in a row before a really tough road trip. You know, something we've kind of lost track of. This team's shooting the ball pretty well.
Yeah.
And number one in the conference in defense as well. You know, nights when you can't rely on your offense, you're on the defense, but you've had some good games shooting the ball. I mean, this point in the season, you really happy about that?
Well, I think I think tonight you saw 54 in the paint, so you better shoot it pretty well if you're taking that many field goal attempts in the paint. But I like the way we're shooting the ball. I think if we're really going to continue to improve as a basketball team, I'd say the one thing I'm really, you know, we're guarding. Maybe we had a little slip on Wednesday against Catawba, but. I'd say the biggest thing we got to really focus on, we just got to take better care of the ball. I sometimes feel like we've been trying to run. We've been trying to go a little faster. I think you can see that in it. We're pushing it. We're going the other way. And I think sometimes we because we're young, we take pushing the ball as in play really fast. And, you know, that's not what it is. But I think we'll continue to get better at that. I like what our guys are doing as far as the shot choice that they're making. I thought we took maybe two tonight that I thought were questionable, and the rest of them were great shots.
First game against the old Conference Carolina foe went well on against Queens. A little headset problem there. Good to go?
There we go.
All right. But first time went well against Queens. You get Coker, who's coming in, your old friend Schmotzer, who one of your least favorite games ever. At Wingate was that Coker game here a couple years ago in Cuddy. But, you know, they're kind of been a strange team. Their women are the same way. You can't really up and down, win some games you wouldn't surprise, surprising you. But this is an important stretch for this team. You've got to win these home games with a brutal road trip coming up. It's going to be the silent game. Expect a good crowd.
Yeah.
It should be a good game Wednesday.
Yeah, well, with Coach Schmotzer's teams, I know what you're going to get. And, they're going to play really hard, run good motion, and play good man-to-man defense. And, you got to be prepared to play. If you're not prepared, they'll grind you away and they'll beat you. But if if we're ready for that one on Wednesday, I think we'll do a lot of things to each other that we probably see in practice. So we should be able to do it. But, you know, I think we've said this the last couple of years, and our coaching staff talked about it, after Catawba game, is we all have the, you know, looking at the end picture, and I think sometimes we get caught up in that. And I think we went back on after Wednesday's game, we said, you know what, we played Brevard, and that's what we got, and now we got Coker, and let's worry about that. We can't control we can't be controlling four games down the road. So let's worry about the one. If we start thinking ahead, get ahead of ourselves, I think sometimes we don't play with the energy and effort that we need to. And I think our team is good. But I think our team is really good when we play really hard. And we're tough to beat when we play hard. And sometimes you start thinking about the wrong stuff. You don't always bring that same energy.
Coach, enjoy the weekend. We'll see you next week.
Absolutely. Thanks, Ryan.